I'm Christine. I'm the Project Manager of Transformations. I work at Kew Neighbourhood Learning Centre and I'm coordinating the relationships to bring together this project, Transformations, between Kew, Greater Melbourne Metropolitan Cemeteries Trust and the students who are coming to us from Burke and Beyond. The pre-accredited learning space is a particularly powerful and exciting space for learners who have been marginalised or for some reason not part of the traditional learning pathway, and it's an opportunity to find where their space and what they'd like to be and what pathway they would like to have through training and to employment. So this program through horticulture is working very successfully because of the partnerships we've formed. We formed the partnerships through the project that's been funded by ACFI, and it's been funded as a capacity and innovation fund project. Very important because it does give us that opportunity to work on those new opportunities and further the progression for our students, and as I said, particularly the marginalised students, and find those new ways of pathways to employment.
So my name's Helen Linehan. I'm Senior Supervisor of Operational Excellence for Horticulture. So my role here with the GMCT is to help facilitate the Kew Neighbourhood Learning Centre to bring them on board and to undertake a pilot program, which is a fantastic initiative and we're very excited to be on board with it. And what it is just provides a pathway for employment for these young students. Once they leave school, obviously there's a big gap between school and the learning environment and also in employment. So we're just helping build a little bit of a bridge to guide them and support them from their transition from one into to hopefully the workforce. And teach them those things that we take for granted every day, those basic life skills, how to get to and from a site, how to take instructions, how to give instructions, how to work as part of a team, and how to think independently for themselves. Northcote is quite unique. It's at one of our smallest sites, so it's pretty much basically two house block sites. It's got a German history and heritage to it, so hence why there's a lot of German headstones. There's a few Irish ones in amongst it as well, from the 1800s, and it's pretty much a closed site. And as you can see, as you scan around, there's a lot of brickworks. Northcote used to have an actual brick factory and a pottery here, which is quite famous.
I'm Sue Laird. I'm the tutor who's been involved in this project from the outset. I'm also a garden designer and I have seemed to have taken on responsibility for developing an overall concept and plan for the whole cemetery. And the idea is to draw on the German heritage in two ways. One is because most of the settlers who lived in this area came from the northern part of Germany, I've drawn on the a landscape in that area that's known as the Lüneburger Heide, which is a kind of a heathland area that has a few trees and then lots of perennial plants. So we're looking to create a naturalistic sort of planting that will be really lovely from particularly midsummer through to winter time, and it will hopefully create a nice place for people to come and just walk their dog or just have some form of passive recreation. The other historical link is that many of the German settlers who were in this area initially were growing roses for the perfume industry. And so my idea is that we will also have a rose garden, and in both the rose garden and the naturalistic plantings, we're going to try and source as many plants as possible that have German names. So for example, with the roses, there are roses called Gruß an Aachen, which means greetings to Aachen. Tantau, it's actually named after a German rose breeder. And with things like the salvias and so on, there are lots of German forms of those. So we're going to incorporate those into our design as well. And the students, of course, are going to be propagating many of the plants that we will use. And so, they're very excited about this prospect of going literally from a small plant to a large, beautiful garden. Hopefully in a 12 months time, there'll be something really, really good to look at. And we're going to do the whole thing in stages. So we'll start at the front so that we've got that street appeal happening and entice people to come in and gradually work our way to the back of the cemetery.
This project, we do about all kind of stuff. We do shovel and planting and watering, mulching.
And we're also getting an arborist consultant who will be helping us design where to plant trees. And because this garden is quite bare, it's really a great opportunity for us to make it our own and really see the transformation of this cemetery into something amazing. I've definitely seen their growth and their maturity. Surprisingly few people you had to start with hand over hand leading them as they go, and now you just, can you plant those plants over there, and they just automatically do it, knowing everything they need to do and can act independently. Some have even told me that they've done some gardening at home because of this course, which is absolutely fantastic, and it's what we want to see. A lot of people before they started didn't know much about gardening, but now every time when we have a catch up with them, we ask, where do you see yourself working? A lot of them answer they really want to work in gardening or horticulture or nursery now, thanks to this program.
The students who are involved in this project are actually learning basic horticulture skills with a view to going on to further training of some sort, or perhaps taking up a traineeship somewhere. The whole idea of our course is that they learn how to manage tools, how to use them for how to work out which tool to use for different purposes. They're learning how to do everything from propagating plants to planting them out, working out the kinds of designs that would be suitable for different situations, and then managing the plants afterwards, so watering them, deadheading them, pruning them as appropriate, and so on. And they're also learning other skills such as managing themselves and working as a team, and also supporting other students, so that if one student can do something really well, they're then encouraged to help other ones develop those particular techniques. And it's envisaged that on this site, where everything is possible, they'll also learn how to do things like tree planting, rose pruning, and so on. So they're all useful skills that they'll be able to apply to work at a later stage.
So on the Fridays, we do horticulture course in Northcote Cemetery, and we're doing modelling and plants and reading.
Hello, I'm Barbara. I'm a tutor at Kew Neighbourhood Learning Centre for the horticulture group. And I've been involved in this program for a while, teaching the students some of the basic skills in horticulture, such as weeding and pruning, planting, hedge trimming, deadheading, that type of thing. It'll be a pathway for them to look at, say, a Cert 1 in horticulture at a TAFE institute, things like that. So it'll give them the basic knowledge to be able to perform well in that environment. I love the enthusiasm of the students. They come to the class with so much energy and so much interest and willingness to learn. And seeing them progress from week to week is just very rewarding.